This is Stomp, and they make music out of everything. Stomp is the brainchild of Luke Creswell, a 30-year-old rock drummer who makes rhythm the whole show.
But it's got more than that. It's got it's got humour, it's got very bold performance, it's got very bold shapes.
Yeah, that's great for you. But again, you'd have to do the same each time.
No.
So the other time, come back.
Luke Creswell began as a busker. That's British for street musician. Steve McNicholas, Stomp's co-director, was his partner on the street.
And I think it's probably a good idea, suspension straight up.
Luke was always looking for different ways of playing the drums within on the street. And he used to play around with dustbins, trash cans, basically.
Luke's obsession took him from the streets to short films like Mondo Biondo. And even into television commercials.
When you were a kid, did you just go around banging on things all the time?
Yes. Yeah, I'm afraid so. I think rhythm is the key to the show. That's what we use to anchor everything on.
It was a big step for us to do a show that was just purely rhythmic, and we really thought that we would turn a lot of people off. Thought it would be quite a select group that would really get into it.
Students, people who go to the arts, people who see things, and that was the audience you got. But then they'd come back with their mum, or their kid, or the bank manager. By the time it finishes, you've got a very mainstream audience.
I thought it was great. I wanted to get up and dance.
Surprising, fun.
It was most original, very entertaining.
What do people like?
I think they like energy. I think they like the old-fashioned sense of people giving their all. And I think they like the idea that you're using props that they might use every day.
The performance is highly choreographed, exhaustively rehearsed.
Luke kind of runs rehearsals like a little rhythmic dictator, basically.
Yes!
It's really hard work. It's hard physical work, and it's also there's a lot of counting.
Yes, and again. 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3, 4. Same one.
But it's also gathering props, making props. That's always difficult because we break almost everything we use. We trash things, we trash brooms, we trash trash cans. It's mayhem, basically.
Everything's different, each routines are different. I mean, it's like the walkers, the old drums that you walk on. I mean, that was a drawing. It was a series of little drawings of, little men standing on oar drums saying this would look great if we could do it. So then it was a case of making an oar drum up, me getting on it in between shows and trying to walk on it. Then everyone else saying, no, I'm not doing that. And no they watch you and then it's, oh, well, I'll have a go, and then all of a sudden you then develop a routine.
Ultimately, there is something very universal about rhythm, which I think we've tapped into. It's definitely a kind of celebration of rhythm and sound. I think if people come out of the show and the next time they're sweeping up at home, they hear rhythms when they're, as they sweep. Or the next time they're running down the stairs, they hear rhythms from the sound of their own feet. If people listen differently after they've seen our show, I think we've had some kind of success.